There are several tools and technologies that you can learn as a big data engineer in 2024 that will fetch you a very high amount of money, a very high salary, whether you are working as a freelancer or you are working for a company. These technologies and tools are going to fetch you a very high salary and consider you as an expert in this field. If you are new here, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel to stay updated with our content. At number 10, we have CI/CD pipelines. GitHub Actions, Jenkins, and Travis CIs are tools that are revolutionizing the way we automate testing, release, as well as monitor data application. As the complexity of the software development increases, these tools are crucial for accelerating delivery. They ensure that new code changes integrate smoothly into the existing system, making the entire process more efficient and reliable. At number 9, we dive straight into streaming analytics, where we have tools like Apache Spark, Apache Flink, and Kafka. These tools are leading the forefront of the revolution, and they are the one in charge when it comes to streaming analytics. These technologies are key for real-time data ingestions, processing, and decision-making. They unlock operational analytics by focusing on event-driven architectures, as well as enabling reprocessing capabilities so you can replay your data as they come through the system up to the end. Number 8 brings us to infrastructure as a code, where we have Terraform and CloudFormation. These platforms are transforming how we handle infrastructures, allowing teams to version control and automate provisioning. This not only enhances reproducibility across different environments, but also streamlines the entire deployment process. Coming in at number 7, we have enterprise data warehouses, where you can think of Snowflake, BigQuery, and Redshift. These technologies are optimized for business intelligence workload. They are leveraging column-based storage and SQL. They are essential for organizations that are looking to make data-driven decisions from big data. At number 6, Python takes the stage. It is the powerhouse for ETL processing, feature engineering, as well as machine learning. Thanks to its versatilities and libraries like Pandas, NumPy, scikit, PyTorch, Keras, TensorFlow, amongst others, Python is a go-to for data professionals that are looking to streamline their workflows and bring models into production. Breaking into the top 5, we have the containers orchestration, where we have Kubernetes sitting comfortably in this space. Kubernetes is essential for managing the scale, availability, and portability in distributed systems, whether on-premise or in the cloud. Kubernetes pods abstraction in particular allows unparalleled resilience, where if any of your pods goes down, it automatically recreates itself and another one takes its place. At number 4, Apache Airflow makes the mark. Apache Airflow is all about orchestrating complex data workflows, which is directed as cyclic graph, which is the DAG. Airflow efficiently manages workflow dependencies, parameters, and error handling, and not to mention its robust observability features. Number 3 is all about databases, from normalized SQL like Postgres to NoSQL databases like MongoDB and Neo4j. These databases cater for a wide range of use cases, from transactional processing to analytical workloads and semi-structured data management. Just missing the top spot at number 2 is AWS services. This includes services like S3 buckets, Glue, Athena, and Redshift. AWS provides a robust platform for serverless building blocks, supporting cloud data lakes, ETL processing, and analytics. It is a comprehensive ecosystem for any data-driven organization. And drum roll for number 1, Apache Spark. Apache Spark is very important and very key for unlocking big data capabilities. It has unparalleled distributed processing power, and it handles massive workloads at incredible speeds. Especially when you integrate it with Kubernetes, it offers resilience and scalability like no other. If you are looking to get started on any of the tools and technologies that I mentioned, check the link in the description for more information on how to get hands-on. And you can also enroll in my one-on-one mentorship, where I'm going to be taking you through the entire journey of becoming a master at data engineering. In the meantime, you can also check the videos in the channel to get you started on any of these technologies. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.